Good morning, it's 103.5, the happy hour. It's a sunny day here in America, Great Britain, and Germany, with partly cloudy later this afternoon and a 5% chance of rain. Traffic is looking steady but slow right now, with a few accidents sprinkled here and there. 103.5 The Happy Hour would like to remind you that the following show may contain strong language and other content that may not be suitable for a younger audience. It may also contain spoilers for any and all anime and manga, so check that description for all spoiler warnings. So don't change that dial, we're about to hit you with some quality conversation here at 103.5 The Happy Hour!
Hey, so we got for our third period.
I'm gonna be smoking.
I got mad.
Because I'm so cool.
I have already graduated. Why am I here?
You were held back.
I have a job.
Oh, wait, that's the bell.
Hello, class. You look like a bunch of freaking delinquents. So I'm your teacher for this semester, Professor Manimal. There looks like a pretty bad lot of you, so I'm going to now do roll call. So do we have Simon, otherwise known as Vacant?
Here, sir. Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Take your freaking hat off in the building.
Listen, this is my cowboy hat, and I will wear it with pride. It symbolizes my national...
It's disrespectful.
Okay. All right, then.
You can't go against the system forever.
I will fight your sister.
Then you will try.
But I will fail.
Next, do we have Nairbons?
Yo.
Get the gum out of your mouth.
Okay.
Oh, that was relatively simple. Okay. Lastly.
I don't want to get detention again.
Do we have...
You're not supposed to be here.
That's right.
My wife is worried.
Do we have a hope for the future?
No. No one's got any hope for the future at this show.
No hope here.
Okay, looks like you're not doing anything too extreme. All right. Today we're gonna do a podcast.
And scene. Woo! That was brilliant. We should go into voice acting.
We should never do that again.
That should never. We should just start this recording again.
Yeah, it was so good we could do another take.
Third try.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Manga Raiders Community Happy Hour, episode 54. As you may have guessed, with all the professors and students and teachers in the house, this is a very special back-to-school themed podcast, so welcome aboard. All those little school kids, all those who were homeschooled, and all those people who've graduated, like Nair. Look at this fancy pants guy. Just because he's graduated, think he's better than us all.
I'm wearing basketball shorts.
Yeah.
You're not even pants.
I'm not even wearing pants, man. I'm not even wearing pants, and for all your knowledge, you can't prove that.
I'm also wearing shorts.
I'm just not wearing anything.
That's pretty cool.
You don't need to know. You don't need to know what I get up to. It's how I podcast. It's how I feel comfortable.
I mean, you can do whatever you want, man.
That's exactly... That's the motto here. Happy hour. We should fuck voice acting. We should just run for like to rule the world, and then we could just be like, yeah, man, do what you want. You want to be bottomless under a table? Be bottomless under a table. Go for it, pal.
I mean, I can already do that, but
I feel like that's a narrow list of policies for taking. Why would you want to be in charge of the world? Well, basically, we want to make sure everyone has the freedom to be able to remove their bottoms when they wish.
I guess, like, in public, but even if you could, I still wouldn't, anyways.
That's true. Oh, my God, that's just reminding me of a story that I've read. I'll go back to that before we do that. Was a little thing that we need to do. How was your weeks, guys? What the fuck have we been up to?
It's been the same as always. There may have been something last week, but as you would imagine, there's nothing this week except for... No, there's nothing at all.
That was a segue to a interesting story then. Like, except for... Blah, 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 I was on the bus.
Except there's no interesting story.
At the end of it. Nairbons! I heard on my little weathercaster thing that I have. I don't, that's a lie. There was an earthquake by you.
Yeah, I slept through it, but it's... Facebook is all a Twitter. It's all the buzz today. So.
Motherfuckers, there was an earthquake. I saw it. It swallowed my car. I don't know why I gave that voice to anyone from, like, any Facebook follow people. That I couldn't even get my words out then. I don't even know what I was attempting to say.
You racist. Listen to that accent. Jesus.
This is episode 50-something of our podcast.
This is Manimal calling me a racist who said something earlier that we probably shouldn't air.
No, I mean, you know what? I'm the Manimal. I'm here and I'm jamming.
That's racist because you're trying to rip off Bob Marley there. I'm jamming.
That was not Bob Marley, but no, if you want it to be.
He says I'm jamming.
This is a good time for me to not be in the discussion.
Woo!
Hold on a second, wait. Okay, never mind.
Never mind.
Keep going. Forget that
on
ever happened.
Nah, so you survived an earthquake, you're okay.
Yeah.
Now you've had a newfound lease on life and you survived a near death thing of a tiny earthquake that didn't wake you up. What have you been up to?
Well, I've got a 3-day weekend. My work partner's back, so I've got more free time. I'm probably going to be writing now that my apartment is empty except for me. And
does that mean that? Is that proof, definitive proof, that Corin stopped you from writing? His presence inhibits you?
Yeah. Yeah, let's go with that. To heck with that guy.
Hey, fuck you, Corin. No. Oh, I'm only joking. I love you, Corin.
I've also been trying on cowboy hats.
Have you?
Weirdly expensive.
That somehow escaped my notice that you've been trying on cowboy hats. I thought there was something different about you.
Man. I'm just so sad. You may have seen in my picture, nobody recognizes my hat for being quality. It's like $140.
Whoa, fuck.
It's not a cheap hat, I'll tell you that.
Jesus, I didn't realize. When you said pretty expensive, I didn't realize you meant that expensive. Good lord, what are they made of? Why are cowboy hats so expensive?
Leather and... Also, I have a big head, so it takes a while to find a hat that'll fit me.
You just need one of them big hats.
I can't. That picture is ruining my life right now. I feel like I can't do anything anymore.
Yeah, you ceased to function ever since you've seen Nair in a cowboy hat.
Because you guys have double up pictures of this.
I changed. All right, I go.
Then it's in the chat, too.
Let's explain it. Yeah, let's explain this. Yeah. Basically, when we came on air, Nair had a picture of him with a cowboy hat on, which we'll probably share on the show. And as a joke, I decided to make my profile picture that, so that's what Manimal is looking at. And he just stopped. He ceased to function as a human being. Like, he can't comprehend. He can't function when he sees it. And to be fair, there is about, in my eye shot now, there's about 3 pictures of all the same of Nair with a cowboy hat on. I think I've accidentally made it my screensaver. I'm not even sure. I'm going to have to double check that when I go back.
Who has screensavers anymore?
You can set screensavers. Every screensaver at work that I have is Harambe. It says, rest in peace, Harambe.
Who actually uses screensavers? What
when
decade is this?
You lock your fucking computer. It's an expression of personality. We'll not have you. Right now... Me and you are going to draw the line. I will fight you over the defend screensavers. That's what's going to happen right now. It's going to be a duel to the death, good sir.
Screenscape.
Love my screensavers. But anyway, moving on. Hope, how's your week been?
Yes. Oh, yeah. Nothing, basically. Well, I did have a friend's day over for like the week. So
you've been chilling out.
Nice.
No, nothing else. We basically did nothing the whole time, so that was fun.
I'd like it to be literally nothing. Yay. Like he came through the door.
It could.
Came through the door and you just went, hold it right there.
Just sit there and do nothing.
Yeah, like literally a week's like, worth nothing. Of nothing. Just like you come through the door.
Just like stare at the wall all day.
Come through the door and just goes, whoa. We ain't doing nothing. Just chill. I'd like that. I'd like that image. But that's good. I need to ask something as well, because this is the back to school feature. Are any of us actually going back to school, or are we all wily veterans? Yes.
The wild return for me.
Manimal is going back. We should mention Manimal, obviously, is over the age of 18. Just so he's allowed to swear.
Am I?
I'm sorry. No, Manimal is an unspecified age. He is returning to school.
I'm 12.
You shouldn't be watching most 11. Of the things you do.
I'm advanced for my age. I went through my leapfrog like no one else.
Fair enough. But Manimal's, so Manimal's going back to school. And are you, did you say, sorry, Hope?
Oh, no, I'm not. I was just kind of like, eh.
Meh.
Like, eh. Like, I'm joining a back-to-school special, and it's just like, nope, not going to school, so I don't know why I'm joining.
Well, this is good, because this isn't really here to talk about us going back to school. Although Manimal very much has the stage to do so if he wishes to.
I'm scared. That's my basic
point.
Do not worry,
Manimal, because you are in the right place, because this very podcast is dedicated to all you people going back to school. We're here to alleviate your concerns. We've traversed that road already, and we're going to tell you it's going to be A-okay. Unless you are a minority, overweight, homosexual tendencies, transgender, of another ethnicity, of another religion, have ginger hair, have freckles, have excessive body hair, any of these things, you're going to have a bad time. I'm sorry. It's
all right. I'm good.
I'm none of those things. I'm all of those things combined. It cancels it all out. It makes me the coolest guy in school.
You certainly are cool.
Yeah. You'll be okay.
In our school.
I'm too cool for school. I made a promise to myself I wouldn't say that, and I've just said it. So I'm sorry.
Now you did. I did. You've ruined the show.
I am quitting.
Ruined this episode.
Oh, shit. It's just the Manimal quitting. Oh, no. This is going to go down.
Hi, I'm back. This is the reunion tour.
Woo-hoo!
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a faster reunion than...
The money was calling, so I had to come back.
There you go. You can't make dollars like this on the road. Do you know what I mean? Just ain't gonna happen.
No, I can't do solo shows. It's just not as profitable.
That's true. You don't sell as many tickets when it's just your name on the door.
No, and I have to play at crappy theaters, and I don't like doing that.
Up. Anyway, let's kick on with the show. Let us kick the fuck on with this show. So
yes, let's get it on.
I needed to say something.
Please.
I'm gonna go back because I think we mentioned something about being naked. I can't remember. But basically,
well,
I was looking around for news, like as I always do.
For nudes?
News. NEWS. Yes, I typed in Manimal nudes. Probably don't do that. There'll probably be bad things on there. Knowing the internet. So
literally.
Do not do it. I was searching around for some anime and manga news, as I normally do, and there is really nothing going on, to be honest. There's like,
no, not really.
It's a slow week in terms of anime. I mean, Mario Maker's coming to 3DS. Any yay or nay for that, guys?
There's a lot of stuff coming to 3DS. I'm sad that the 3DS version of Mario Maker won't have like the online option.
Yeah.
From what I read,
he said it was big on local share. Whatever that means. Mm-hmm. I don't really know.
It means you're never going to share with it because, well, I'm not, because I'm in the middle of fucking Kansas, and not everyone has their 3DS as they traipse around the farms.
That's a good point.
This would work great in the crowded streets of Tokyo, but, God, Street Pass is kind of super dumb.
It is, really, unless you're going to, like, an airport.
These are my opinions, sorry.
If you're going to, like, an airport or something, or a... like, you know there's going to be a meetup of, like, gamers, then yeah, that's fine. But other than that, there ain't really.
I've still never seen a human being playing Pokemon Go before.
Really? You're the only one.
I haven't seen anyone play that game.
I've seen a lot of people.
Yeah.
Me included. I was playing.
I also don't see a lot of people either.
I just don't see people, man. Do you live on an island, Manimal? Are you, like, just in an island somewhere in Canada where there's no people?
It's secret. Okay, Nair is on camera. He's loading the game. He's trying to get me to... All right.
Oh, he's...
This is... He's doing facial expressions I don't appreciate.
You do appreciate them, though.
Or maybe I do appreciate
them.
Okay,
we can now see. Let's do a play-by-play. Nairbons is actually playing Pokemon. He's just pressed a button.
But his frame rate is so terrible that I can't even tell what he's doing.
Look at this.
Also, there's a glare so you can't see it. Let's move on.
It looks like he has some varieties of like body soap, deodorants, and something else behind him.
There's varieties.
I think that's what it is. Oh,
you
I was
body
right.
Body wash and shampoo and deodorant.
He was right.
Why do you keep your body wash in your room?
My bathroom is right there.
Yeah, that's really
Nah. I like talking with you guys. It doesn't matter.
It's amazing.
But yeah, so that,
we can salvage this.
It was a slow week. It was a slow week for news. So instead, I just went on to the normal news. I just decided to go on normal news. And I'd like to share a story that I found. I did find one that initially I thought was interesting. A zoo asked the internet to name its newborn baby gorilla. Who can guess? 10 points. I guess we'll grade each other. This is a school episode. 10 points. To whoever can guess what the internet decided the gorilla's name would be.
Harambe Jr.?
Absolutely Harambe. That was all that they got flooded with. Rest in peace.
Good.
R.I.P. Harambe.
He lives on in our hearts.
And our memories.
Wherever we let our dicks out.
Hashtag dicks out for Harambe. Send those pictures into Manimal. Yeah. He'll enjoy it.
Oh, yes. Please do. I want all of the pictures.
All of the Harambe dicks. Maybe not pictures of Harambe's dick, but dicks out in show of respect for Harambe. So, the story...
I think I'd prefer the gorilla in this case. Okay, so at the anime con before for the hentai panel, we watched this thing where there are these like schoolgirls that went into like this magical hot springs.
Okay.
And they all got dicks.
Okay. Right, let me wind this back, because that was a sharp left turn. So do you know this hentai panel? There was a bunch of people in a room together. Okay. Let me just get it straight. So there's a bunch of people in a room together, and all watched hentai together?
No, we were just looking at like clips of stuff, and it was funny. Like, it wasn't awkward or anything.
Were they
it was hilarious.
Almost like satirically, like where they were like, "Oh, look at this," or were they like, "Guys"?
Well, no, they were like, "Here are the sites we like to use. Here are our favorite artists."
Oh, right, okay, so it was a fan panel.
Yeah, what'd you think it was?
I was thinking it's like hentai creators trying to shill something. No, it was just a guy going, "Dudes." This is one of my favorites.
I told you there's less than 500 people here. This isn't a freaking anime expo.
Yeah, but the same. Out of those 500 people, they managed to... someone went, "I want to do a hentai panel." And they went, "Do you know what? That's just what this con needs."
They do one every year. It's funny.
Yeah.
And I found out that Honoka's the voice actress in Love Live. Do you guys know JAVs?
Let's say no.
What's Jake?
Well, it's live action stuff.
So it's just porn.
it's apparently super common.
Why didn't you?
This is new information.
Voice actress did it before Love Live.
So is it porn?
Yeah.
Why didn't
it's
you
like,
just say porn?
It's like the videos are like an hour long. They're like really long and slow.
But porn can be so long and slow. I mean, you don't need the full hour. Let's be honest. Like, you know. You just skip to the highlights, you know. Not that I would know.
Well,
any
I guess the point of these, you just put them on and it sets the mood.
I guess. I mean, I wouldn't know what girl would like me to just go. Like, normally when you set the mood, you think of stereotypical things like a bath, rose petals, candles, sensual music.
And a JAV.
Yeah, sensual music, and then it's just... I would love it if instead of JAVs even, just like, just hentai. Just like, oh, come on.
A JAV of Honoka's voice actress.
Let's just... Hey, baby.
You're sure that doesn't stand for, like, Japanese audio visual? And it's just...
I'm
like,
pretty sure. It stands
Japanese
for
adult
video.
Yeah, I was going to say, wouldn't it be Japanese adult video?
Yeah.
I, for some reason, in my head, I thought of Japanese anime video, and then I was like, no, wait. That doesn't make any sense.
That doesn't, yeah.
Anyway, came back to...
Okay, but no, I could talk about the this week and this season or whatever you want to call it, a little update on the summer season.
Just before...
Because I haven't done this in a while.
We can get into some actual anime.
All right.
Yeah, sure, fuck it. I was going to read a news story out, but whatever, fuck it. It wasn't... we'll move on.
If you say so. So, I'll do an update on the shows that I'm keeping up with. A Manchu, really good show. Again, super slow paced, and like this last episode was about like the girl's phone fills up because she takes pictures of everything, and she's like, "I don't want to transfer my pictures to my memory card." But it was a whole thing. The show is super slow, but I like it a lot. Anjay
Verdiger,
whatever.
Anjay Verdiger.
This show, again, I've said before, there's a bath scene in every episode, and then in this episode particular, this one girl gets slapped 3 times by her best friends. That was pretty weird. It's a weird show. It's entertaining, and there's a great voice cast on it, but it's a weird show, man. Banania, legend. Love Life Sunshine, now that the group has come together in Sunshine, it's a lot better. It's still, because there was a lot of really moody drama in the last couple of episodes, and now it's all been resolved, so the fun antics can begin.
I don't like Love Life went moody.
You don't?
Yeah.
I mean, that's a bit sort of, I know there should be some kind of tension and stakes, but like, yeah, if it took...
It went super moody really? In the original, like, yeah. No, yeah, Love Live always goes really moody, and there's warm moments in every episode, basically. But the Sunshine is doing good. Maso Gakuin HXH is doing some pretty crazy things. I think that everyone needs to see it just to witness it. It needs to be witnessed. It can't even be explained, the stuff that they're doing in the show.
For the plot, right?
Yes, for the plot. There's actually so much freaking plot in the show. It's ridiculous. I'm not even joking. They try to have like an actual story. And it's like, excuse
me. Welcome back to Manimal Justifies His Taste.
It's ridiculous. I mean, it's a bad show. Like, the animation is god-awful, and it's terrible. It's just fun to watch. There's basically a scene. You guys know the opening of Halo 2 with the Arbiter?
Mm-hmm.
It was that, except with lesbians.
That instead of lesbians. That's
so...
That tagline could be applied to so much anime. It's unbelievable.
Yes. So that's what that was. And then New Game. I really like New Game. It's doing really good. It's fun. It's a nice, comfy slice of life. Obviously, it's nothing like what a real video game office would be like, but it still kind of does feel like a real office at times, because... There's one character who keeps them in check and everything, but I like New Game a lot. It's really nice and colorful, and it's a pretty show, and it's enjoyable. Narugaro has... There's, like, no one consistently subbing the show, so it's still at episode 5. And
oh,
Orange,
my God! I have not watched a Narugaro episode 3, 4, or 5.
I know. Maybe you gotta do that another time, but then Orange has completely train-wrecked. Oh, my God. The animation is terrible in episode 9. Holy shit. Like, it's beyond bad. I can't believe, like, there are so many janky frames and animation glitches. It actually ruined the whole episode. And I don't really like where the story is headed either. I think it has a good idea, but I don't like where it's going right now in the animation.
12 episodes. That's the problem so often with these short ones. These kind of, I think that's a problem that I see with these ones, that now if they've gone a lot shorter, anime tends to, like these seasonal anime, they sort of, because they're a lot shorter, they have to think of ideas, but the ideas tend to wrap up after about 10 episodes, so they have to try and sort of elongate them out, and I just don't feel...
It hasn't wrapped up, it's expanded, and I don't like the way it's expanded, because it's become a Cupid story, and I don't know. I don't really like where it's going right now, and that's basically it. Again, this summer season is pretty light. I think Love Live Sunshine and New Game are the only good shows this season. Everything else is... Oh, no, a Manchu as well. But the other three, Anjay, whatever, Maso Gakuin, and Orange are just like, eh. You know.
Fair enough. Well, you mentioned New Game, the summit that I neglected to mention today. I have a new game, and that's Attack on Titan, Wings of Freedom.
Is it the best you've ever played?
Oh,
I had to pay a little over the top for it because I did a digital download because I could not find a physical copy anywhere. So it was 55 yeah. quid. So £55, whatever that is in dollars, about $70, maybe. I don't fucking know.
Well, that's how much video games are now.
Yeah, well, this yeah. one was about... I was looking online, and it was about 20 quid cheaper than that if you ordered it online. However, do you know what? I was like, this is a lot of money for a game like this, and I wasn't expecting anything from it. And it's not a world beater, it's not the best game in the world, but it's pretty damn satisfying to...
Yeah.
Like, they've... I'll give them the dues. They have gotten down the omnidirectional gear, the ODM gear, and like moving throughout cities and moving throughout.
So,
forests.
What kind of game is it?
It is a mission based, so it's linear in terms of missions, but it's open world in a way. Like, as in, you are given a map. And you have this area to run around, and you have little side missions. It's not exactly, I mean, I haven't played tons of it. It's not exactly clear what you're doing, really, but it follows the first season. So, like, do you know the Trust District, for instance? Like, that's really the first big mission, the Trust District, where you've got to subdue some titans and stuff, and they attack that supply base when you're Mikasa. They attack a supply base, and you've got to sort of defend the supply base, but you've got to sort of defend the other people around you as well. Really satisfying to take a Titan out as well, I'm not going to lie. Like, the novelty has not worn off yet of attacking Titans. Like, you just launch your anchor into them, and then you can, like, speed up, and then you've got to time your attacks. I just thought it'd be like a button mash kind of thing, but if you just button mash, yeah. you totally miss. You have to time when you're close enough to them, and when you're fast enough, and you have to aim for them. Pretty fun. It's way better than I thought it was going to be. I'm not going to lie.
It's probably exciting until you become a Titan, just like the actual show.
Hey, well, I've caught up.
Play as Eren.
Yeah, you can play as Eren. I haven't got as far as him turning into a Titan yet. Like, well, tell like he has spoilers for Attack on Titan. If anyone hasn't watched it,
I think everyone knows that by now.
But,
yeah, that's kind of
basically the part where he's a Titan running around. You play as Mikasa. And you guys have got to get to the supply depot thingamabob. Why Eren's just sort of running around killing Titans, and you just sort of help him.
Again, that's when the show just totally went downhill, and the whole idea just ruined itself.
Well, if you've watched, I don't know are you up to date in the manga?
No.
Very much does the thing, because to me, all intents and purposes, Attack on Titan is a post-apocalyptic... It's basically zombie steampunk, like steampunk zombies. It's just the zombies are bigger. That's the only difference to me, really. It's the same thing.
Steampunk zombies is Cavanary.
Well, yeah, they made that as well, Studio Wit. Obviously, Attack on Titan is based on a manga, but like, they're just zombies. They're mindless. They're slow moving. They're just like unstoppable. They have to come. They're hard
they're
to kill.
Kind of more like, you know, Titans.
No, I mean like,
I was like zombies. I'm like, okay.
No, in terms of like, they just have a one motive is just to eat humans, and they've driven them to the brink of extinction, and they now rule the world. So it's written very much like a zombie story. Obviously, the steampunk elements with the ODM gear and how they fight them, that's all different. So with most zombie flicks and zombie series, you tend to see that the zombies are the main enemy. Then they sort of learn to handle them, as it were, and set up a secure space, and then other humans become the enemy. And that's exactly the same as what happens in a manga, where the main antagonists are other humans, sort of, at least in the arc, the following arc from it. I won't go any further because I don't know if everyone's up to date, and obviously we don't want to spoil it to everyone. Season 2 is coming out in the winter season, so you'll see all that anyway, so it's not that long.
It's actually coming out in the winter season.
Oh, right?
Winter 2017, it should be out. So,
I didn't know it was so soon.
Which is so it's weird to say winter season so soon, but yeah, 3 months' time, maybe? Well, hang on.
Wow.
That's more than 3 months. That's in January.
4 months' time.
Beginning of January.
4 months' time. I was getting ahead of myself. 4 months' time, it'll be here.
Jesus.
We could be talking about the first episode in 4 months to this very
My God. Let's not think about that. Oh, my God. I don't even want to think about 4Ks right now, dude. I'm shitting my pants, believe me.
This is... Yeah, let's get back. Let's move back onto what we were on, because we've gone off the rails with what we were on. And that
You've
was school.
Gone off the rails? That doesn't work on bass. Never mind.
has anyone else been watching or playing anything that they want to discuss before we hop into our main topic of the evening?
Oh, go ahead. Oh, no, I started watching ReZero, and I'm...
Yeah!
I just didn't want to get into it, because
it's so popular?
Because I'll find spoilers, like, no matter how hard I try to avoid them. I'm at, like, episode 9 right now.
Boy, that show is much better than I thought.
Look here, I tried to watch the first episode. I hate the way the main character looks, and nothing about it grabbed me. So I canceled after like 5 minutes.
It gets, I don't know. I think, no, he's still pretty annoying. But
like, I want to watch it. I want to know what happens in episode 18 or whatever the big episode was.
Yeah, but, right. The I Love Amelia one, right?
I don't know. I don't know anything about the show. But
okay, I thought we needed to set up episode 18. I think that's
one of the best.
I know it's a big one, but I haven't seen it or anything. But again, like, you know, I was wrong with Konosuba. I thought it looked boring, but it was actually the best show of the winter season. But
that and Konosuba are probably my favorite.
I saw you talking about it, actually. Yeah,
Konosuba's fantastic. Genre. It's such a brilliant show.
Yeah,
like it's just such a great comedy. And it's so unlikely, too, because it's just such a boring concept. Anytime I see guy gets thrown into game world, it's like, screw off. Get out of here, you know?
Right.
But, no, I'd like to see ReZero, but it didn't really grip me. I don't know. I guess I just wasn't in the mood for it, because I'm watching Kimi no Toda K2 right now, and that's pretty different.
I don't know what that is.
It's a show.
Yeah.
It's the one with the girl with straight bangs, and she's like a ghost girl, and she's not a ghost girl, but everyone thinks she is. It's super duper slow.
I know this one.
It's so slow. Oh my God. It takes her 5 minutes to say one sentence sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Safe. Okay. Sweet. Right then, we better move right along, because it's school. We've got sessions. We've got things to do. Fucking
yes.
Busy.
Oh, wait. Hold on. The bell's going to ring soon.
We've got a very jazzy bell, haven't we?
Bell.
All our school budget went into developing the bell. That's why we ain't even got uniforms.
Oh, I'll do a walking bass line. That wasn't really a jazzy bass line.
Doesn't matter. That'll do. I'm not fussy with my bass lines. I'll take the first bass line that comes my direction.
Yeah.
I don't know if I'm supposed to talk over that, so I remain quiet.
Any moment now. Persona 5 is getting the Daybreakers anime special, which is either a prequel or a side story or something, but that should be on Crunchyroll.
Prequel.
Soonish.
I may stay up for that. We'll see.
All aboard the hype train.
Woo-hoo! Oh, dude, I'm so excited.
I'm so
hyped.
A few
more months now until it comes out. It's like, that game is coming out in Japan very soon.
Then we have to wait.
I will probably be listening to the soundtrack until it comes out here.
Yeah, I'll be the opposite, where I will literally, I'll literally just, as soon as it comes out in Japan, turn off, like, just do not ignore anything and everything to do with Persona 5 until it's out here.
I'm bad with spoilers, because I want to know.
Yeah.
And I don't care.
This is one thing that I do want to, like, normally I don't give a fuck about spoilers. I'll read ahead myself, but I don't know why, just with Persona. I guess it's because Persona's never been spoiled for me. So, I'm going to try and keep it that way. I'm quite good, like...
I was just going to say, how can you spoil a fighting game? But then I remembered...
It isn't a fight. Oh.
I know.
Manimal.
I know. That's why I didn't say that aloud until right now.
I'm going to deduct points from you. From House Manimal. We should have...
You know, at the con, I had a choice between the 5th anniversary Mugi Lucy, Catgirl Lucy in a bikini, and Arise.
Uh-huh.
I was really debating about Arise, but I went with Moogie, and that was the best choice, definitely.
You got Moogie right there.
Arise.
Have you got Moogie there? Wait. No,
Moogie's upstairs. I really like that Moogie figure. I keep looking at it. It's such a nice figure.
But yeah, I'm so excited for Persona 5. Final Fantasy 15 will tide us over until then. And then, hopefully...
Thunder Returns, that's my favorite one.
Good old Thunder Returns. I love that one myself. My personal favorite of Slight Rain, too. But, yeah, I guess we should roll on quickly. Shall we do a bit of discussion before a challenge, or shall we do challenge first?
You want to do the challenge first?
Let's get the challenge out of the way. Yeah, because okay, it could turn into a long one. Manimal.
This is my exciting Guess That Anime Tune Challenge.
Woo.
So basically the point is I'm going to send these guys a Google Drive thing that has 10 clips of anime songs, and they're going to have to guess. There's 10 of them, so if they guess 5 correctly, I have to read a terrible fan fiction, or at least a few paragraphs.
And yeah, not all of it.
Then vice versa. No, I'm not reading all of it!
I said not all.
Remember how
long we were here last week reading fanfics?
Yeah.
That took a long ass time.
Okay, so here we go. So basically the rules are you play the clip, and if you know it, you go beep or whatever, and I'm like, what do you got? So you guys collectively have 2 guesses for all these.
For all?
Wait, yes. 2 for each?
No, you have 2 guesses per song, I mean.
Okay, I was going to say, how the fuck are we supposed to get 5?
Oh, yeah.
You just go, I'll go like, okay, go to number 1 now, and you go to that. I'm trusting you guys not to cheat for this one, so.
You are right, trust me. You have Scout's honor.
And yeah, again, Vacant, just pause it as soon as someone says beep, just so that's not in there, you know.
Okay, I'm just,
here we go.
Hang on, we will have the 2 in rapid fire, they'll be quick succession. And we will, whoever gets it. So what's the time limit?
You guys, okay, the song, the clips are about 15 seconds. So as soon as you know, if you know what it is, just go like beep. And if you don't, you have like 10 seconds after the clip to guess or something like that.
All right.
Okay, I think.
All right.
I think I've got it.
So here we go. So just click on number 1 when we all have it up.
Okay. Can I just say I found my buzzer as well? Will you accept this as a buzzer?
Sure. Anything goes, man.
Okay, so, all right.
So the first one, right?
First one.
Yeah, don't click it yet. Don't click it yet.
No, shouldn't click it.
We've got to do it all at the same time.
I'll reopen it.
Yeah, don't click it yet. So all of you guys, as soon as you get it loaded, just tell me. As soon as you get the page loaded.
I have the page
loaded.
Can we mute,
like, the Skype, or...?
What?
Can we mute the microphone or just...
Oh, you don't have to worry about that.
We're ready.
Okay.
Okay. So, everyone, you ready?
I'm ready.
Never.
There?
Demute it. I'm ready. Remuting.
Okay. Oh, no, it's fine, man.
Hit number 1.
You don't
Let's
need to
go.
Be muted. You're fine.
Hit number 1.
Number 1. Hang on.
Go. Okay. Wait.
Okay.
Start?
Ready.
Yeah.
My Google Fiber superior.
No. All
right, go.
Rick Astley, Never Gonna Give You Up.
No.
Done.
Dang.
Number 2?
No, the rest of the song, the actual one.
It was Never Gonna Give You Up.
It is.
What?
I said Rick Astley, Never Gonna Give You Up.
No, the actual clip after that.
It took you a goal.
Oh.
Yes, you got it. All right.
Yeah, I'm like, I kind of figured you guys would have gotten it first.
You said...
I didn't recognize it. It was just Rick Astley.
I was turning on that too. I was like, what?
Oh, this...
Okay, that wasn't the reaction I was expecting. I thought you'd just be like, ha, funny,
you guys
and move
just
on.
Know that?
Well, no, because I listened to the beginning of the fucking clip.
Okay, you got it. All right, number 2.
For God's sake, these better not be. If these are all like this, I'm going to fucking flip.
Number 2.
Right, number 2 is playing now.
Play it.
Erased.
Yeah.
Woo.
Erased.
You got it.
Tell us when to play number three.
Number three.
Oh my god. Alright.
Number three?
Still have not figured out number two. Are we on three now?
Sleep opening 13 by SID.
Yes.
I also do not recognize number three.
Number three is amazing.
All right.
Number four.
Number four.
Go.
Okay, I've never seen three.
I have no idea what number four is.
Hold on, I actually gotta go see what number four is.
Ladies and gentlemen,
okay, I don't know
Manimal's game.
What?
Okay, number four is the opening of Sabaji Boo, whatever.
Oh fuck, I should have got that.
Yeah. Number five.
I skipped the opening to that, I'm not gonna lie.
I know.
I also skip openings.
Number five?
Yeah.
Number five.
Okay, number five.
Oh, I know this one.
Go for it.
I
got it?
I don't know.
I know it, I just don't recognize it.
It's Nozaki.
Oh, fuck. Was it really?
Yeah. Nozaki-kun ending.
God.
Like, I love that song.
I should have known that.
Okay, so wait, you guys are at three, correct?
Yeah, we got the first three. We haven't got four or five.
Yeah. What was number three?
Number three was Bleach. Number the 13th opening.
Yeah. All right. Number six.
Here comes number six.
Number six.
Fairy Tail, second opening.
Yes.
Bush. Okay, we're up to number four. Seven. If we get this one correct,
you gotta get one right. Tale. But we're gonna do all of them.
Okay, number seven.
We're gonna do all of them. But okay, number seven.
Someone get six yet?
Yeah, we got six.
Yeah.
That is Konosuba. Wait,
yes.
Is it?
I adore this song.
Shit, sorry. Woo! I can't hear both at the same time.
Yeah. Okay, you beat me, but let's keep going and see if you get the others for bonus points.
Number eight.
Number eight.
Great.
I need to find a full version of that one.
Oh. This is Yui, Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood, first open.
Yes, again.
Fucking yeah.
I'm not getting any of these things.
Okay.
Number
nine.
We have Vacant on our
number
team.
Number nine.
Alright, I'll stop.
You know number nine?
I don't know it.
It sounds so familiar, but I just can't think of what it is.
Huge Pen Ball Pen K-On. It's one of the insert songs.
Fucking should have thought it was K-On. They said Fool
yeah.
Fool.
Alright, number 10, last one.
Last one.
Number 10.
It's a jazz version.
Hey, Ava.
Yeah.
I can't believe the first one. Right, I'm still annoyed at the first one. I was just
that didn't go as I planned.
God damn it.
So it looks like you guys have beat me at my own game. Maybe I made it too easy.
There was some obvious. There was some.
I wouldn't have gotten it.
Wait.
I got two. So.
I got two too, actually.
You got it. So...
I think I only recognize like four of those, sadly.
Yeah.
But I was like super late.
Oh, this is all I have to read? That's pretty good. I'm okay with this.
That's mine.
Do we each... Okay.
I'm not reading.
I'm going to look up...
Okay, let's...
The point was that you guys collectively...
Okay, so, Hope, I don't think you were here at the beginning, but...
Oh.
Just before we went on air, Manimal posed this challenge to us, and then he asked us to... If we scored five, he would lose if... We scored below five, then we would lose. And a forfeit was you have to read the worst fan fiction you could find. So, Nairbons.
Only one of your guys. You got to collectively
game. Okay. Well,
we had to read the
story. Nair's sent one already. So, just go with this one.
Okay, this one's all right. I'm okay with
I'm
this.
I'm sorry. I thought it was one. Like,
I did. But mine's pretty shit.
Oh, I don't got any.
Well, I'll tell you what mine was about. Mine was fucking. about Pokemon and it was about Gardevoir. You can guess where it went from there. So, it wasn't what I wrote, by the way.
I'll read this one. This is Doom, Repercussions of Evil. How do you pronounce that name?
Stalvern?
John Stalvern waited. The lights above him blinked and sparked out of the air. There were demons in the base. He didn't see them, but had expected them now for years. His warnings to Colonel Joson were not listened to, and now it was too late. Far too late for now, anyway. John was a space marine for 14 years. When he was young, he watched the spaceships, and he said to Dad, "I want to be on spaceships, Daddy." Dad said, "No! You will be killed by demons!" There was a time when he believed him. Then he got older, he stopped. No, then he got...
Yeah, that older. Is how it's actually written.
Then, as he got older, he stopped. But now in the space station base of the UAC, he knew there were demons. "This is Johnson," the radio cracked. "You must fight the demons." So John got in his plasma rifle and blew up the wall. "He going to kill us," said the demons. "I will shoot at him," said the cyber demon, and he fired the rocket missiles. John plasma at him and tried to blow him up. But then the ceiling fell and they were trapped and not able to kill. "No, I must kill the demons," he shouted. The radio said, "No, John, you are the demons." And then John was a zombie.
That might sound familiar if anyone will listen to the last one. Did you include that just to atone for us totally misinterpreting what you wrote last week?
Maybe a bit. I felt compelled to teach and impart wisdom.
It was wise.
It really, really was. Shame on you, Corin. Corin, just for the record, was the one who said that it was five ever that you wanted to do. It wasn't five ever.
Yeah.
Five ever. Amateurs.
Yeah, Corin.
And also, I spelled all the names right when I was doing that. He butchered them in his pronunciation, and that was not correct. I appreciate it, but...
Well, shit, that was the challenge. That didn't take as long as I thought, but it was just as messed up as I imagined.
Yes, it was.
God damn it, Rick Astley! I bet this video is going to get fucking pulled now because of that beginning.
Oh, that's on like every YouTube video in history.
I know, but ours are always unlucky where we get pulled. Fuck you.
Well,
YouTube is always
take
an awesome.
A chance.
I'm gonna, of course, I'll take a chance. It's too hard for me to edit it out. I'm too lazy for that shit.
Wow, that was the thing that happened.
Yay! That was a fan fiction. That somebody, can you believe, sometimes though, with these fan fictions, there are people who, like, we write ourselves, we devote a lot of time to writing, and you know how writing a short story can take days, weeks, months of planning? There are some who do that devoted to weird fanfics. I guess if but you know this, the back to school.
That's what they want to do, though. So I'm not. I want to discredit somebody who wants to do something
I've got
like
to,
that.
I mean, I've got to praise the creativity because I saw one that was literally a erotic story between Hogwarts Castle, the building, and a giant squid. So whoever's mind put those two together and decided that was story worth, like that, they deserve a fucking medal. I don't know in what field.
Supposedly. The longest continuous narrative in the English language is a Super Smash Brothers self-insert fan fiction that's like 12 times longer than the collected works of Shakespeare.
Oh my.
That is amazing. Like, it amazes me that these people have.
Again, you know what? It's, if someone wants to do weird stuff like that, there's a market for it. People like it.
We're talking about
someone's jacking off to it, so their purpose has been succeeded.
I want to find... Actually, no, remove that remark. I don't want to find the people who are jacking off to giant squid and castle porn. Like,
okay, I'm not talking about that one. I'm talking about the stuff that I sent you.
Yeah, well, which you may hear something later.
Thank you for sending it to us for some other reason, then.
The rest is too weird. I'm not sending
it.
Could,
could I get the rest of it, please, just for personal reason? I mean,
okay,
yeah, there are some weird ones. But hey, as you said, to be fair, fuck it. If that's what you're inspired to write, then go nuts. Why not?
Exactly. It's the same thing I was saying with, like, creative voice and stuff. If that's what you want to do, then freaking go for it. And I give props to the people who can put that on the internet, you know?
You said that really weird, put that on the internet.
Well, you know, like, they freaking put up this, like...
I know what you mean.
Again, I give props to people who have the guts to put that stuff out, you know, and be like, this is what I like to do.
Is that a new challenge? Yeah, we've got to make the weirdest... Can we make the weirdest erotic fanfiction ever?
Oh. No, I'm let's do that for the next episode. I'm going to do Moogie X Cake. I'm actually going to do that. I'm not joking. I'm going to write... I'm gonna
is
do that.
Cake a character or an actual cake?
No, Moogie X Cake.
So it's going to be...
I'm actually going to do that. I'm serious.
So it's about
right
Moogie
now.
And her ex, who is Cake.
No. Sure, like, it could be... Cake's oh, like that makes it... That adds a whole new element of drama to it.
Exactly, see?
Her ex Cake.
This is an ex Cake.
Okay, I'm doing this, and whoever's on the next... Well, maybe not the next episode, but whoever's... Someone's reading it. That's the point.
Somebody out there is going to have to read that. Now,
I'm still not sure if this is a specific character named Cake, a cake, the dessert, or the band Cake.
It's all
of the above. You
want it to be. Yeah. That's the
She's
magic.
Going and the distance. Hope. She's going for speed.
Well, let's see. There you go, Manimal. Make sure she has distance and speed in that relationship.
Can you go the distance? We will find out.
About 2 minutes. So, I mean, no, we're not, I thought we were talking personal. Moving on. Now,
anyway, so this is somehow a back to school episode. I want to do a chronicle. This is a selfish thing, but I just want to do this for myself right now.
Okay, okay.
And get into a little bit of a real talk, if you don't mind.
Okay, we've had the fun challenge. We've spoke about some random shit. Let's... Do you want to do some real talk? Shall we lift the...
Let's do a little bit of real talk.
Let's go for some real talk then. Let's bring it to some real talk.
Okay, so as I said, I'm going to college this year.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, this is like a pretty big decision because I've had 2 years off. And here's advice to all you people who have recently graduated high school. Get a freaking job right now. Keep a job. Because... Mm-hmm. I can tell you from my experience and having 11 months of glorious unemployment that you become so comfortable at your house that you don't want to leave it because it's so nice, you know?
I think I did the exact same thing, actually.
What was that?
Like, I didn't start working until, like, a year after graduating, I think.
Oh, really, eh?
Yeah, like, I was just thinking, I'm like, oh, wow, okay.
But see, you get so comfortable when you're just at your house.
Yeah.
Because... You can just rely on your parents and be like, this is awesome. Like, last year was totally awesome. Last summer was amazing. I had no responsibilities. All I had to do was cut grass. That was it, you know? But it's just, you don't want to get in that kind of mindset, you know? That's not good. It's not good at all.
That's true. That is true. That's very true.
Don't do that. That's my word of advice.
So don't get in a rut. You got to keep believing yourself, basically.
Yep.
Yeah. Because, I worked somewhere right after high school, but that place closed a few months later. And, again, it was freaking fun being on. It's a fun being unemployed. I was sitting at the mall one time. I was looking at everyone. I was like, these people all have to go somewhere, but I can sit here for as long as I want.
Yeah.
I got nothing to home for. That was kind of an amazing feeling, you know?
It is, until reality, but...
Exactly.
Yeah.
It was like, I can totally relate because, not last year, the year before, 2013-2014, I was off sick for a few months, both around the same time of each year, due to recovering from operations both times, so I had two operations... in 2013, then the following year, and then I was off for a couple months for just recuperating and just being off work and having that 3 month period of not working was amazing. Like, I actually loved it because much since school, since I left school, I went straight into full-time work and I have not had a substantial break between them. The only one I could really say was when in between me being made redundant and getting a new job, but that was 6 weeks. And I knew I basically got the job 4 days after getting made redundant, but they weren't actually physically starting me until 6 weeks later. So I knew I had a job.
Got it right
it
away
was
like
perfect.
That.
So I was like, okay, so I've got a 6 week vacation, and also redundancy pay. So it was like an awesome holiday. I just remember playing Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 for ages. Like just me and my friends who all got made redundant were just sitting there playing that for a long time. Awesome time.
It's like you get so comfortable and you're just at home all the time.
Exactly.
That when you go back to a workplace setting, it's like you're different. It's just so different.
But
because my second job, that didn't work out for me. But it was like I could have made it work.
Yeah. I know what you mean.
And it would have been very good because it was a high-paying job, you know.
Yeah.
But
because you're so used to
it didn't work out for me because I was still in that mindset, you know, of, ho, 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 it's so fun. But
ho, ho, ho.
That's what I would say to anyone who's just graduated high school. Get a job and freaking hold on to that, man.
Yeah, fair enough.
You know?
This is the back-to-school advert. Back-to-school episode. Yeah, get a job.
Again, I'm going to school now, and I'm freaking so scared about it, man. But I know that everybody else is too, so it's not like I'm the only person who's worried about it in the world.
Oh, okay, well, here's what you we know. Should do, Manimal, because you are a very esteemed and well-respected member of the Happy Hour. I think me and Nair,
I don't
Hope,
know about well-respected, but
me, Nair, and Hope should attempt to alleviate any concerns for you and anyone else listening who is worried about going back to school. We're doing some real talk now, so I'm going to try and keep any jokes to the minimal. I'm going to try and be totally
serious.
Yes,
this is the real talk segment.
Real talk.
Freaking read this Doom fan fiction.
Yeah, we like to switch to a little bit.
Dug through the crusty outside and
we're
in that creamy middle.
Nair in a cowboy hat.
I want advice from Cowboy Nair. Just looking at that face, I'm sorry. I'm doing even too
I was in such a real talk mood, but I looked up and...
Oh, shit.
I looked up and because Ness said...
Okay, anyways, yes, what were you saying, Jacob?
Real talk.
Jesus Christ.
Okay.
Thank you for making that.
Showdown. Polly. Okay. Don the Polly.
Yes. But as I was saying, I'm pretty worried about it. Hopefully I can listen back to this and be like, you're an idiot.
It's
all right.
Yeah.
But
we know it will.
I don't want to jinx anything. I'm pretty big on not jinxing things. Okay. So.
Well, we know it will. Ultimately, in hindsight, any new job, any new school or location.
Since I've had so many months to think about this, I applied in March, and I just it goes from like that sounds all right to this is a terrible mistake. Why did I do this? You know.
Yeah, I know. I know
the only reason I'm going is because there's nothing else for me to do, and I don't think that's a good idea. I don't think that's what you should do, but it's all I can do. You know.
Yeah. I think what people miss out on when you're not in school or you're not in employment is very much the social side and just having a routine.
Miss out on the world. And
yeah, yeah. Meeting different people, meeting different people, learning different things. Like, these are things that will all work to expand your knowledge, your horizon, your
you're
cultural
not
understanding.
You're not going anywhere sitting at home all the time hoping things are going to come to you.
That's very true. If I had to be totally serious and try to give advice to you, Manimal, I think you will be absolutely fine. It is a scary place. School?
Yes.
It is a scary place.
I've been in the building
a
couple of times. But again, I've seen some other new students as well. They're all even more worried than I am.
Yeah.
You know?
As long as you're not on the bottom of the pile of worried students, you won't be targeted, so you're okay. No, but... What I say is, like, it is a scary place. There's thousands of people, hundreds of people who go there. There's all... it's like a pressure cooker for... not stereotypes. I'm not sure what the word I'm trying to look for is sort of cliques.
Everyone.
Yeah, like cliques.
Yeah.
And, like,
I'm not worried about
these things.
Stuff like that. I just... That doesn't worry me, but...
What are you worried about, Manimal? Are you worried about the actual academic side, or is
I'm worried about if it's a bad idea or not, you know? Because, well, that's why I waited so long. I didn't want to, because, you know, everyone always tries to rush you right into it after high school.
Yeah.
It's like, got to go to college right now, or otherwise you're going to be a freaking loser bum. But, you know, and then I've seen so many people who have dropped out so quickly, you know?
Well, you know what, Manimal? Yeah. Manimal, if you go to college for a year and you don't gain anything from it, you don't feel like it's worth your time and you drop out after a year, that's not the end of the world. Perfect example. My brother, oldest brother, he went to college, went to university. He dropped out of university because he wasn't interested in what he was doing. He was too busy. He was the age of wanting to party, wanting to go out. He wanted to do that a lot more than he wanted to study. So he dropped out. He just got a average paying job, just a normal job. And then he...
McDonald's.
Fast food industry. Just around that job. Yeah. Just something that pays the bills, something that's no, you know, a thankless task. Something.
Hey, it's still work experience, whatever it is, man.
It pays the bills. That's all you need. Ultimately, that's what your job is. It's something to provide income for you to live your life. That's how I view them. And he started back at university years and years later to do music production. My fucking words have gone terrible. Maybe I need to go back to school, fucking learn English, and that's talk.
Yes.
I need to learn how to put them fancy words in sentences. But so he went back.
You just used the word fancy. That's pretty advanced enough.
Fancy is pretty fancy, coincidentally.
Right.
But he's gone back years and years later. He has studied music production, and it's something that he's really wanted to do. And even though it's taken years for him to think what he wants to do, he's happy with what he's doing now and settled. So really, like, you, if this doesn't work out, it's not the end of the world. And I'll say that to everyone who's going to school. School does not define your life. Whatever you go to study now, if you want to change, you can. It is never, ever too late, no matter how old you are, to change what you want. There are people who go university and college and medical school, and they're in their 60s, 50s.
Yeah.
You're never too late to do that shit. I mean, you know, ultimately, if you want to do something, you do it. Like, it's fine. You can. It's not the end of the world.
You go for it.
Yeah. Just don't be.
Yeah.
Just don't be the kid who walks around with a Kirito shirt on, because then you will be.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That's me, all right.
Yeah, Manimal. Stick to Love Life. Stick to Kill la Kill. Love Life. You'll be okay. Maybe Attack on Titan cape. I've seen kids running around with them.
I puked. I'll wear my Love... Okay, I probably won't wear my Love Life shirt.
Quick
there.
Side story. I've just said the cape thing. Other day, I went into town, and I saw a group of kids, and several of them wearing scout capes from Attack on Titan.
Oh, come
whatever.
On.
Whatever. It's not my
They're doing their thing. I've seen kids wearing tails and everything like that, so whatever.
Whatever, if you want to do that. But one of them, as I walked past, was on the phone, and she said the words, Dad-chan. And I was like, that doesn't make sense for a start.
No.
I was like, for a start?
No. Are you serious?
Sense. Oh, I'm sure... She went,
how about
Dad
you use the correct
term?
What's the word for dad again?
Onisan.
Isn't it,
No, not Onisan.
Otosan?
Otosan. God, I've just embarrassed myself. It is Otosan, isn't it?
Yeah. Okasan is ostrich.
So ostrich is for mother.
Yes.
Otosan, isn't it? Yeah, Otosan. Otosan!
I don't want to say these words because I can't pronounce any of them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm pretty certain that is the one. But...
Oh my god, it was such a feat for me when I learned how to pronounce Haruhi Suzumiya. I don't know why, but that was like so challenging for some reason.
Was it? Oh man. I could always pronounce it.
I don't know.
The melancholy... It's a mouthful. I just said I could always pronounce it. Melancholy Haruhi Suzumiya. But yeah, fuck knows. I don't know. Yeah, it is a Tosan. But yeah, come on, Dad-chan. A, that's not correct. Like, that's not correct.
Get out of the house.
And come on. Your dad, unless your dad told you to call him Dad-chan, maybe he just wants to...
Oh my god, can you imagine if the dad's like that too? He goes home, the dad has the freaking cape on.
Dad's dressed in the full, like, Scout Legion
thing. His freaking tight makeup on.
Yeah, he's like, come on, motherfucker. Make my day.
What would you do if you went to your parents' house and they were wearing tight makeup?
Sie
sind die Jäger und wie bist du denn? Start running.
I'd whip out my ODM gear and I'd be going to town on them bad boys.
Yeah.
Yeah. That'd be weird because I guess, like, there will be parents like that in this generation in the next 10 to 20 years, I suppose.
Are those people going to reproduce?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, they can find, you know, it's easy for those people to find love, you know, in their communities.
What happens when furries have a child? Did he raise the child to be a furry? Or did he let the child decide if they want to be a furry or not?
That's a legitimate question.
There's a forum post that answers that question, but I don't want to find it.
That's like a legitimate...
That's what I'm going to do after we've gone off air. I'm just going to do some furry research.
No.
Furry research doesn't sound... It's not what it sounds like, believe me.
Yes, research.
But, yeah, getting back to it. So school, I guess to wrap this up, the school talk, the real talk. I don't know how I can go back to real talk after we've just said those things that have just been said.
Well, I think we've said it all.
Sum it up, guys. Any advice? Nah, hope. Any advice for anyone going back to school?
Keeping a job is a good starting point, yeah. You don't want to lose momentum.
Yeah.
Yes. That's the big thing. Even though it's fun, it's not beneficial.
What about the kids going high school? What about the kids who are, like, too young
for a job? Get a job!
Okay, this is what I say to kids going in high school. It's not the best years of your life, number one. It's just normal school.
Hey, Dawson's Creek told me otherwise.
Yeah. I mean, of course, experiences vary for everybody, but it's just normal school. Just have fun. You know what? This is what I would say to myself in grade 9. Join the frickin' concert band, you loser. That's all I have to say.
Is that you taking inspiration from Orange and taking the letter back to...
No, because I freaking... Okay, I watched Hibike Euphonium last November, and I was like, why didn't I join the frickin' concert band? Jesus Christ. I literally can't even imagine why I didn't. I always complain that I've never played with anyone before, but I had a chance right there, you know? So...
didn't.
That's what I say to you people out there. Frickin' go for it.
So you didn't join the concert band. The what was it? Sorry.
Yeah, which is like, you know, all the... Not like these instruments, but, you know, like the fancy ones.
The fancy ones, the brass band.
Yeah. I mean, there was stage band. I played bass with them for a little while. We did like a disco Star Wars theme. That was pretty cool.
That actually does sound pretty cool.
I wasn't a very good bassist at the time, and the drummer kept looking at me because I kept messing up, so it wasn't the best.
See, that's what runs into problems at school. People judging you.
Again. Come on.
It's just such a good disappointment face because it's almost like a smile, but it's not.
It's fun,
literally
man.
Just like masking your disappointment. Disappointed sigh or something.
You gotta post this on the forum.
That's
so
what I mean. It just looks so...
Where is the website that you put the text on that? Please.
I'll send it to you.
What facial expression is that? Like, how did you decide like that was it?
I don't know. I was just taking pictures of myself. That's my attempt at a selfie, I'll be honest.
Yeah.
It's just brilliant.
So perfect.
That's disappointed Nervons. It's like a father who doesn't just... Oh, you just let him down.
Yeah, you're trying to hide your disappointment, but you can't. You can't form a smile all the way.
Well, that's... Look, give me a second.
No. Yeah, so that's what I would say to myself.
Fair enough.
That's it, though. Everything else, just whatever, man. Don't worry about it.
Advice to you high schoolers. That's best advice I could give. High school is literally, well, barely the beginning.
It's not a big deal.
Of your life. It is barely the beginning of your life. You are just growing up, and you aren't even the person.
Don't hang out with the wrong people. Yeah. Oh my god, the freaking Nair is ruining the episode. That's where we went wrong. That's also where we went right.
Cowboy Nair, brilliant. Oh, sorry. These are all, I'm just going to have to put these into the video so people can see what they
are. Yeah.
Good lord.
This is a good website. Thank you.
I feel like
I'm going to have so much fun with this. Oh,
the only reason that I discovered that website was just in the office when people kept doing dumb shit. So I'd just start making like memes of pictures and just started sending them across. And it's like,
hell yeah.
When motherfuckers stop, motherfuckers keep stealing food out the fridge. You'd put that with a little face on there. But yeah, advice to high schoolers.
If you just graduated high school, buy this album. It's by an artist that I sometimes talk about known as Bruce. It's called Born to Run. Listen to that.
Listen to that.
Yeah.
Get some inspiration. But yeah, if you're in high school, don't worry about it. Don't, you know, it doesn't.
It's not.
It doesn't
have
matter.
Have fun. Don't hang out with the wrong people and just go with it, man.
I was going to say, you can't do a lot in high school, but you can fuck your life up considerably, I guess,
yes.
If you were. I've seen some people do it, like if you take
oh my
the
God,
wrong
totally.
Road.
I know.
So
many people want to grow up so quickly, you know.
Yeah, man.
Like,
I did.
Freaking just take your time. There's plenty of time for that. Provided that you don't instantly die in a bus crash. Then, never mind. I ruined my point.
I wouldn't want to die in a bus crash.
Laughing
either.
At a bus crash.
Please don't die in a bus crash.
I wouldn't want to
you
die.
Like bush crash?
You said bush crash.
Like, don't die.
I mean, I feel like the bush might increase my chance of survival because it would cushion the blow, but...
But it's a spiky bush.
Oh, no, no. They're not
poison good. Ivy.
Oh, fuck. You fuck, man. You're absolutely fuck. I'm still looking at that fucking meme that's... I'm still looking at that picture.
I know, it's... Come on, man.
But yeah, yeah, it won't, like, that's a good point. People try to grow up too quickly. And yes, high school basically attempts to mold you into an adult before you are, with the rigidity and the rules and all that kind of thing.
Out of the house.
This is a good website.
I don't even know what I'm trying to say, though. Oh
we
my
can't
God.
Have real talk. Real talk is cancelled.
No.
Okay. Let's
good.
Yeah, fuck it. Fuck it. Let's get back to it. We can do real talk.
Hold on. I got a big one more that says when real talk is
canceled. Oh God.
That's it, I'm making one. Fuck.
This is no. Never try to have real talk.
We can have real talk, but it's just not tonight.
Not
I don't think we're
Cowboys involved. This wasn't the episode
cowboys.
For real talk.
Oh, dear Lord.
Maybe it also is. Who knows?
We got some real talk going out there. But yeah, I'll attempt to finish my point again. Yeah, you try to grow up too fast. Don't worry about fucking high school. It doesn't matter. Just keep your nose clean. Do what the fuck you want. Chill out. Try not be too much of a cunt, though, because... I've always yes. said this, kids from the age of 10 to 17 are the biggest bunch of cunts in the world. So if you can navigate that period successfully without being too much of a cunt, then you're okay. So there you go. That's all I've got to say about it.
That's sound.
That is...
Go get a haircut too. Get a nice one. Get some style.
Yeah, get some fucking... What, who are you? You fucking still got that 2008 Justin Bieber hairdo? What the fuck? Get into 2016.
I mean, you can style
now.
That.
Nah,
you
man.
Can... You could be John Lennon circa 65. That's a good look.
Yeah, I suppose you could. Why don't you get the One Direction? You know, get some jeans that are nice and tight, you know, that cut off circulation to
Harry
the testicles.
Harry Styles, there's a picture of him wearing a Kiss shirt, a Hot in the Shade tour shirt, and it was like, are you serious? Do you like Kiss?
Oh, I'd be hot
okay.
in the shade.
You know, if he does, that's cool, man.
That's very cool if he does. Probably doesn't. Maybe he wore it just... Cause
I don't, you know, that's the thing. Everyone likes to assume that all these people are posers when they wear shirts like that. But just because they're a pop artist doesn't mean they don't listen to stuff like that. Like, there's like Lady Gaga always wears like Iron Maiden shirts and stuff like that. Everyone's like, what a poser. But that doesn't, just because you make pop music doesn't mean that you don't like other stuff.
Yeah, that's true. You know? Just because we listen to one genre doesn't mean we don't like another. So that's very true. Fuck real talk. Mm-hmm. Fuck the real talk. We're going. Let's wrap this
get
shit
out
up.
Of here.
Let's get the fuck out of here. Cowboy Nair, star of the show. This was the back to school episode, kind of. We sort of had a music lesson.
We're ending it already?
I mean, I don't know, shall we? We can carry on for a bit longer if you want. Fuck it, let's carry on. What should we do next?
I don't know what we can talk about, but...
Do you know what? Shall we go all the way back to my little news story that I found that I wanted to...
Yes, this is the exciting climactic news story.
Okay, well, now we've built...
We'll do a little bit of a smooth news intro for this. Do you want to do it in, like, a smooth radio voice?
Yeah, I could do it in a smooth...
I'm going to do a bit of a smooth intro.
No, I want it to be, like, an epic, like...
Well, I can't... I have bass. Okay, hold on, I'll figure it out.
Okay, give me something mellow. Give me something mellow, then.
Okay, I'm going to play with my fingers like a true pro.
Ooh, I like it.
No, that's not it. That's not the groove.
Okay. I feel like we're not going to find the groove in a while. Did you find your groove? Okay, we'll just...
No, I didn't like that, but just go anyways.
Never mind, let's just fucking go. This just in, hot off the presses, mass naked fight on French beach when clothed teenagers stared at women.
What?
Nice. Go, France.
Here's the whole story. A huge naked fight broke out on a naked beach in France when a group of male teenagers refused to strip and just stared at the women. It has been claimed. They are said to have gone to the beach. This is the first part of the story that I don't believe is real. Listen to the name of the beach. La Teste de Bush.
Get out of here.
In Arcanon, Bordeaux. And they started acting provocatively. Teste de Bush. La Teste de Bush. Witnesses said that there was around 10 of them. They started staring at the women. This is contravening to the nude beach etiquette. They were told
Oh my God, you're at a nude beach.
This is the best line.
Why would you be in a nude beach if you don't want people to look at you?
This was the best thing. They were told to get naked or get lost. This sparked a confrontation that ended up with riot control police turning up.
Oh my
up.
God.
Naked Whoa. People were throwing sand into their eyes. There was shouting and punches were being thrown. Two people from Bordeaux who tried to flee were arrested and later released. That was literally just the story, but I just love the idea. The bunch of kids, like, they say teenagers as well. They specify that these are teenagers. So first of all, you've got a problem on La Teste de Beach, La Bush, sorry, where full-grown women and men are telling teenagers to get naked just so they can stare at the women.
Oh.
Only there.
Then,
oh, hold
they
on,
start
I'm gonna get my jazz
master
out. Hold on, keep the topic going.
Okay. And then, like, they start scrapping. Like, that's really funny to me. That, like, imagine fighting a naked person. I can't. I don't know what the noise was. This is painful. Whatever I'm hearing.
That sounds like shit, man.
That does sound like shit.
I got it through my bass app, that's why.
Ah, okay.
Oh my God, that is the worst. That no one should ever have to listen to that again.
Yeah, that's I'm in agreement there.
Sorry, please pretend that didn't happen.
Okay, I'll pretend that didn't happen. Oh no! Right,
never happened.
I wanted to send a meme and I can't because my Skype sort of crashed. But it's still recording, so that's all that we can hope for.
Here he comes now, right. Up to you.
Shall we wrap the shit up? Shall we go home?
Manimal's
checked out, so we better wrap up. Because Manimal's now starting to play the guitar. This is the part where the show officially
I broke
collapses.
My string. I tried to do the Teenage Riot tuning, and I broke the E string. The song's hard.
If there's one, if there's one thing that you need to get through school, it's an E string and a cheese string.
Yeah.
And a shoe string. Any parting words, guys, before we wrap the shit up?
No, I think we've said it all. We had a nude beach. We had fan fiction. We had surprising real talk. And
Cowboy now.
Cowboy. That's oh, my God. Wait. Hold on. Don't stop the show. I have to play this at the end of the show. Otherwise, I have to play this. Hold on. Pause the freaking... I have to look at the tabs for this. I don't remember how to play it.
Good lord.
Okay.
If I don't play this song, then the episode is ruined. So don't worry, I got the acoustic out. We're gonna get a good, a nice tone this time.
Okay, guys.
But make sure you mention Cowboy Nair right before the end.
I will mention Cowboy Nair.
Well, I'm a cowboy.
Okay, guys. It has been real fun, but like any school term, unfortunately, it has to come to an end. So, Hope, Manimal, Nair, thanks for joining us. Any last words from you guys?
I don't think so.
Get
a job.
Get a job.
Get a job.
Get
everyone.
A job, you Ooh. Lazy kid.
I love how the moral of the back to school episode is: fuck, ignore where you're going back to school. Yeah. Get a job.
Basically,
advice on the happy hour. So, I mean, if you've made it this far, heed our advice. And if you do, then maybe a special treat at the end of the episode.
Holy shit! If you've made it this far, you're amazing.
And to treat you, because who wouldn't have made it this far? Let's be honest, we've had nudist beach fights, we've had
we've had it all.
We just had it all. Real talk.
You know what we had the most of?
What did we have the most of?
Cowboys.
I'm not doing anything. You're just a horny little sex doll. Getting the girl even hornier against her own will. A horny little sex doll that loves to be fudged just like an obedient little naughty word. You're cooed and massaged Ryoko's chest. She bit her lip and her muscles turned to jelly, laying her head back like nothing was wrong, but in her mind she was screaming for her to stop.
Oh my
God. The control blushing and moaning buried her struggle for freedom, and even though she looks like she was warming up to it, her hatred burned deep inside her.